In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to create and set up a campaign in Google Ads. This is my quick start Google Ads tutorial. So let's head to Google Ads to get started. I've already signed up for a new Google Ads account at google.com/ads. And the first thing I recommend is clicking Switch to Expert Mode. Now we're asked to select a goal for our new campaign. This is designed to help guide you through the different settings as you create your campaign. But since you're here learning exactly how to set up your campaign, I want you to go ahead and select the option to create the campaign without guidance. This will mean you're in control of the settings you choose. And you can always change these after you've created the campaign. Next, we need to select the type of campaign we want to create. We can see there is a range of options. We can choose from search, display, shopping, video, app, smart, local, or discovery campaigns. I recommend starting with a search campaign because you're already familiar with how Google search works. People head to Google when they're looking for something. They enter a search term and then they get the search results page. This means you can show your ad as people are searching. So by starting with a search campaign, you're already familiar with the experience. You probably already have some ideas for the types of search terms people are using to look for your products, your services, or your offering. Let's select search. We're again asked to select the objectives for our new campaign, but I want you to leave these deselected and click continue. Now you'll need to name your campaign. I'm going to name the campaign Draft Search, but you can name your campaign anything you like, and you can even change the name after it's created. We can now control where our ads will be seen. I want you to go ahead and deselect both of these options. So deselect include search partners, and also deselect include Google Display Network. This means that your ads will only run on Google. The benefit of this is that you know exactly where your ads will be shown, and it will also help focus your budget in the right place. Now you need to choose the location targeting for your campaign. This is about where you want people to be located to see your ads, and it's also about if they're interested in the location you've selected. Basically, if you select, say, Australia as the location for the campaign, it will mean people located in Australia will see your ads, plus anybody searching for keywords that relate to the location. For example, if you start targeting the keyword of hotel and you have the location target of Australia, then people in Australia searching for hotel will see your ads, and people in other countries searching for hotel in Australia can see your ads too. I recommend aiming for a balance when you select your location targeting. Try to choose a location that isn't too wide or too narrow. For example, I would probably recommend starting with a city-level target, since a country-level target can mean your budget might be spent very quickly. I also recommend choosing location targeting that aligns with your existing customers. If you're already generating leads or sales in a particular geographic area, then you can use that to help inform your targeting in Google Ads. So for my campaign, I'm going to select Sydney, Australia as the location. Next, we have the language targeting. I'm going to leave this as English, but you can change this. For example, if you wanted to target ads to Italian speakers in Australia, you could change the language. Then we need to choose a daily budget for our campaign. This is the average amount you want to spend each day. I'm going to enter $10. I need to mention that the amount you spend each day can be higher or lower than this amount, but this is the amount you will pay on average. Now it's time to choose our bidding strategy. Google loves machine learning, which basically means automating things. However, if you're getting started, then I recommend being in control and skipping the automation. So I want you to click Select a Bid Strategy directly. Then click the dropdown and choose Manual CPC. This means you will be setting the maximum you want to spend for a click-through to your website, instead of letting Google Ads automate the bidding. And we can see that Enhanced CPC is disabled because I haven't set up any conversions in this new account yet. However, if you see this option selected, please disable it too. Then I want you to click Show More Settings, and then Add Rotation, and choose Do Not Optimize. This will mean that you're in control of testing ads in your campaign. You'll then see more options. There are options to create different extensions, including site links, callouts, and other extensions. Just leave these, since we can set them up once we've created the campaign. Now let's click Save and Continue. It's time to create our first ad group in the campaign. Ad groups are like subfolders in Google Ads. They will store our keywords and ads for our search campaign. The idea is to include 5 to 10 keywords in each ad group and write a really compelling, highly relevant ad that will be shown to people who search for any of those keywords. 5 to 10 keywords is a general guide. Ad groups can have more or less keywords in them, but 5 to 10 usually indicates that the keywords are closely related to one another. I recommend researching your keywords using the Keyword Planner. So for now, let's give the ad group a name. Let's name it General. Now we need to set the maximum we want to spend for each click-through to our website. Since we haven't researched our keywords yet, let's enter $1 as the maximum bid. And let's skip to the bottom. And let's click Save and Continue. Now, Google Ads wants us to write some ads, but I recommend writing your ads after you've researched your keywords. So let's skip straight to the bottom and click Save and Continue. Once you've entered your credit card information, click Submit. Then we need to click Explore Your Campaign. We can now see our new search campaign in the navigation on the left, along with our ad group. Since we have some more work to do before we want our ads to start showing to people, let's click the green Enabled label at the top. And let's change this to Paused. This means we can work on our new campaign, and then when we're ready, we can change this back to Enabled. The next step is to research the keywords you want people to search for in order to see your ads. We're going to use the Keyword Planner, so let's select Tools and Settings. And then Keyword Planner. Now let's select Discover New Keywords. And we need to enter some initial keywords to start our research. You probably have some initial ideas of what people are searching for to find your business or organization. So you can start by entering them here. For my campaign, I'm going to enter Google Analytics course because I want to promote one of my courses, but you should enter a keyword or keywords that relate to your offering. Now let's click Get Results. We can now see a whole range of keyword ideas. If you haven't spent any budget in your Google Ads account yet, then the insights will be limited, but there is enough to get started. You should spend time reviewing the suggestions and making a note of keywords that you feel are aligned with your offering. There are different ways to use the Keyword Planner, so you can check out the extra resources in the description below this video for more in-depth resources. Look for keywords that are closely related. These can be included in the same ad group. Looking at these keywords, we might decide to have an ad group for course-related keywords, another for certificate-related keywords, and another for training-related keywords. Take time to review the keywords and start thinking about how they can be structured into ad groups. Now let's close the Keyword Planner. And we need to select the ad group in the navigation. Now let's select Keywords. We can now add the keywords we researched to our ad group. Let's click the plus sign. And I'm going to add the keywords that I found. The keywords you add to each of your ad groups are not necessarily the keywords people search for on Google to see your ads. This is because there are different keyword match types. Since we're just getting started and don't want to spend our budget too quickly, I recommend you add the keywords as exact match. This means that people need to be searching for the exact keyword you're bidding on or a close variation of the keyword. To do this, I want you to add a square bracket before and after each keyword. You can also use phrase match and broad match for your keywords. Broad match is where you enter the keywords without anything before or after them. So if we remove the square brackets, these keywords would now be broad match. This means that Google Ads will automatically show our ads when people search for our keywords and any search terms that relate to our keywords. And phrase match is where you put your keywords in quotes. This means that people searching for our keywords, along with variations that include additional words before or after our keyword, will also be matched. Since this is a quick start tutorial, you can learn more by watching my keyword match types tutorial. I've included a link in the description below this video. For now, I recommend starting with exact match. So if you haven't already, go ahead and add a square bracket before and after each of your keywords. When you're happy, click Save. Now it's time to write our ads. So let's select Ads and Extensions. Let's click the plus sign and select Responsive Search Ad to create our first ad. We start by entering the URL we want to send people to on our website. This is the final URL. It's important to spend time thinking about which page you're going to send people to. This page needs to closely relate to the keywords you are targeting and the ad you are about to create. So for my example, I'm going to enter the URL of my Google Analytics course. You can show a slightly different URL to people in your ads using the display path, but let's skip this. Since we're creating a responsive search ad, we can write up to 15 headlines and 4 descriptions. Google Ads will then automatically choose which combination of headlines and descriptions to show to people as they're searching. So spend time coming up with different messages, calls to action, and details about your offering. You're aiming to grab attention, be relevant, and get people to click through to your website. I'm going to quickly enter some headlines and descriptions for this ad, but take time when writing your real ads. You'll see previews of how your ad might appear on the right. And you'll also see some automated suggestions about your ad above the preview. Now let's save our ad. We can see we've created our first ad. Now let's click the plus sign again and select Responsive Search Ad. This time, I want you to click Switch Back to Text Ads at the top. This lets you write a standard text ad. This means that your ad will appear exactly as you've written it, unlike the responsive ads, which will automatically combine headlines and descriptions. I recommend creating a standard text ad, so I'm going to go ahead and write my ad. And I'm going to save my ad. Now we have 2 ads in our ad group, and I recommend you take the time to write one more standard text ad. This means you'll have 3 ads in your ad group, and you can use metrics like click-through rate, conversions, and conversion rate to understand which ad performs the best. This is the start of ad testing and optimizing your campaign. When you're ready, you can enable the campaign and your ads will begin to show as people are searching on Google. There are more things you can set up and configure in Google Ads, including ad extensions, bid adjustments, and targeting. However, now you've learned enough to get your ads up and running while also being in control of your advertising costs. Great work!